Well, welcome along to English Park here for this Connetics Schools Premier First 11 competition final, where you will find St Thomas's versus Cashmere. St Thomas's in the dark blue, Cashmere in their familiar yellow and maroon striped shirts. Cashmere, of course, defending champions. And we're in for quite a contest. And in charge will be Aaron Nottage. He'll be assisted by Liam Hackstone and Harry Lewes. Inexperienced referees here. It looks like we had captains to sort out the toss. Is Captain Ewan Hindman for Cashmere High School. And Jacob O'Connell for St Thomas's. Well, there's not much between these two sides. Of course, St Thomas's are the holders of their Connetics Shield, the Ranfurly Shield style competition that happens within the boys' football. They are yet to be beaten at in the competition proper. Both sides, these sides coming from either sides of the draw. There were 14 teams started out this season in the first 11 competition, and they were split into two groups of seven. Pool A consisted of Cashmere High School. They went through unbeaten. 6 from 6 they were, collecting the full amount of points on offer. And St Thomas's had the one draw, but they also topped Pool B. And they advanced to the premiership. They're the top eight. Cashmere came through with Christ College, St Bede's and Lincoln High School from Pool A. And in Pool B, Shirley, Boys High and Burnside made up the top eight. And after that, the Cashmere boys got through second place in that premiership behind, well, they're second equal actually with Christ College, and Shirley boys led the table. St Thomas's got fourth, where they did lose one game. And they'll stay out with the ball in position. Working the ball across the back. These games usually start off with a bit of a hiss and a roar. Both these sides will have in the back of their mind, they've both qualified for the Boys Premier Tournament, which will be held next week here in Christchurch. So they'll be in the back of their mind wanting to make sure that there's an opportunity here for St Thomas's, as it's Tashe Mashikrima at the top of this St Thomas's attack. O'Connell, number 9, and playing centre midfield by the looks of it today. It's a stream down the right hand side and around, but well defended by Cashmere. Cashmere High School with plenty of representation from Cashmere technical players, of course. Got a good number of year 13s also in their lineup, as does St Thomas's. Well, looks like the crowd's now finding its voice and influence, and really get them behind their teams. Good searching ball forward here from Cashmere, but unfortunately the sideline is crossed, so Thomas's will work the ball down the line. Cashmere working well through the midfield. Nice little change. No real point of attack there from a bit of a hopeful ball actually from Cashmere High School as they settle in and try to find their shape here. Nice work from O'Connell, who shows a good pair of clean heels but pulls up, chooses to work on retention. Eastwick there just working the ball across. Cut out well from Cashmere High School, but unable to retain it. Good work in there from Wolves. Launch forward, has an opportunity for Dempster. O'Connell, no referee seen, but too much contact in there. Well, this St. Thomas's attack spearheaded by Tanchi Mashayakarima. And it looks like Jacob O'Connell and nine on the ball now will join attack willingly. 2 balls on the park, but we're going to carry on. Plenty of space here for Cashmere High School to fashion an attack. Just not couldn't find that connection and easily going through. Eastwick. Now to Steele, who's closed down. And unfortunately there for Liam Kelk. Just couldn't get the ball under control to get a decent ball in. St. Thomas will regroup and start again. Steele. Clips it forward. But Dempster unable to bring that under. Steele. Goes for safety there. Nice work from the captain, Heideman. Cashmere, the ball in the box, but it's Barrett there. Come to the rescue. Neither side just able to get any real flow to their play just yet. Here's an opportunity and the first shot on target, but no real strength in behind that one from Jeffrey Daly. Well, here's an opportunity for Cashmere High School, squared in well, but steals there. Another shot on, the keeper comes out, smothers it. Harry Eastwick very quick off his line there. Eastwick to Steele. Forward to O'Connell. Given away, but retained back. Nice work in there from Walls. Back out to O'Connell. See some space to work in, but it's been shut down by Angow, but the referee Nottage just seeing a bit too much contact. And Alex Walls will launch this one forward. It's an opportunity in there, 80 to O'Connell. whips it in, but nobody's there for St. Thomas's. Cashmere High School with a bit of opportunity here to get some go forward. St. Thomas's trying to get back, gone through. But the ball just getting away from him there. Jamie Jeffrey Daly. Don't see him getting himself into some dangerous areas. Well brought down by Kalk. Well played, good composure in there from Gallagher. He's been enjoying a good bit of territory here. Trying to get about their work here, Cashmere. The defensive shape's okay here at the moment for St. Thomas's, but searching balls, trying to undo them. Well, St. Thomas's, they've, as we mentioned earlier in the boys' premier tournament, they've drawn Selwyn College, St. Peter's from Cambridge, the New Plymouth boys, so I look forward to that contest next week. And Cashmere, they'll be up against Auckland Grammar, St. Pat's Silverstream and Palmerston North boys. Good luck to all involved there. A great chance to see some of the top level high school boys football down in Christchurch. It doesn't come down here that often. Well won by Heinemann. Huge push in there. Well rode. Nice work from Jeffrey Daly. Forward goes Kelp, can't get it, and it's out to O'Connell. He's pretty rapid with the ball as O'Connell, but the defence, the cover defence is strong. And a bit of unfortunate footwork in there is going to present its first corner of the night, and it'll go the way of St Thomas's. Push and shove in the 6-yard box at the moment. Nottage is going to go and just remind everybody of what they can and can't do. Well, Cashmere keeper Lovegrove hasn't been required as yet, but he's going to have something to deal with in here, and he's up and put it down. Where's that ball? Rockets around, but cleared well from Cashmere High School. Well, Lovegrove seemed to have that one under control, but couldn't handle it. St. Thomas is unable to get that crucial toe in there that could have opened the scoring. And we managed to get the ball back. We're starting from a throw here. Cashmere able to clear. Maybe able to turn this into an attack. Well back by Alex Walls. Kalk. Back to Haywood. Driven ball through. Well cleared. Desperate waved on. The referee there, playing advantage. Cashmere consolidating their position through Girling. And just given away, and we'll have to start again. Cashmere. Neither side able to get anything of consequence on target just yet. Here's an opportunity. Struck and finished. What a strike that was. A great cross in from the left-hand side. At Cashmere High School will open the scoring. Can't quite see who got on the end of that one. Bear with us. It was some strike. No chance here for Eastwick whatsoever. Trying to get a good look at the back of the player here. There's his referee Nottage by the looks. Might have been number 9, I think. Jamie Jeffrey Daly, who cracked a lethal left
goal
foot there.
Goal by number 9, Jamie Jeffrey Daly.
Well, that's going to get this game underway, or the scoring underway in the game, which is, from the neutral point of view, absolutely crucial to make sure we get a decent contest here tonight. And St Thomas's will no doubt work very hard here to get themselves level. It's Cashmere High School who have got to give themselves another opportunity. A well-squared ball, and has made it 2. As the flag is raised, just crept offside. Well, it must have been close, but the linesman obviously in the best position possible. It's a decent ball across, and I think it might have been Liam Kelk, one of the top scorers for Cashmere High School. Was there to finish it, but he got himself offside. And fortunately for St Thomas's, and again, the offside flag going up. Cashmere High School really in a good groove at the moment, but just getting ahead of themselves as they try to add to their scoreline. So we just come up to the quarter of an hour mark. Maybe just a few changes here for new positional changes on maybe for St Thomas's to try to navigate their way back into this game. What have we got here? Is it a throw-in or a throw-in for Cashmere? No, free kick. Great battle in the midfield, and Cashmere have got an opportunity to get forward. Bit of an awkward one to deal with for Alex Walls, but he's done well to shepherd that one out for a goal kick that Eastwick will take. Steal. Out to Walls. Promotes it forward, but delivered back with interest from Angout. Walls. Hoping that he's going to get through there. Well, that was quite some challenge. Yeah, that's riled up the St Thomas support. Well, it was Jamie Jeffrey Daly that rocketed into the back of Alex Wall there, but both able to carry on. He's bailed up there. Well, here goes Kelk as he makes his way forward. Takes on a couple of wanting challenges from St. Thomas's player. Delivered in. Steele's got in the way of it. Walls has got in the way of it, but they can't stop the shot. But it's thrashed over top. So a few of the challenges start getting a wee bit of heat on them. The ball fell well there for, maybe it was Ewan Heinbitten there, I think. Quite difficult to see the numbers in this stripy Cashmere jumpers. Yep, Captain Ewan Heinbitten there in the number 8. Oh, a great bit of toe showing here down the right-hand side from the St. Thomas's player. Nice work in there from Daniel Heyman. Yeah, St. Thomas's number 7. Might be one to watch in the second half. And plenty of pace showing all again down that left-hand side of Cashmere High School. That's where the goal came from. Nice move down the left-hand side. Cross was well met by the centre forward, Jamie Jeffrey Daly, to open the scoring. Now comes St. Thomas's. Balls with O'Connell. Under all sorts of pressure, but he rides it well. Oh, unfortunately, he's given it away. Cashmere going to seek an opportunity here. And forward they go. But Barrett's there to the rescue and given up a corner. But he had to be there. That gave Cashmere High School a close on an opportunity to if he wasn't there to get a toe in. Cashmere gathering as a group at the end of the 80. Ball's floated in. Eastwick's there. He's up. Can't get it. Attempted clearance. And here's O'Connell on the ball. Gets the ball forward, but in the direction of Dempster, but can't get it to him. Nice work in there from the keeper to able to pass it out. Now they launch forward, and they once again, the linesman has noted that that run was just a wee bit too early. Minutes into it. Cashmere with the advantage. St. Thomas is going in the direction of Heyman. Brings it down under pressure. Looking for some assistance from the referees there by the looks of it. Heyman on the ball, but no further forward. Heyman dodging and weaving. Managed to get the ball back. Good pressure here from Cashmere High School, but good retention there for the moment from St. Thomas's, but they've had to retreat back to Steele. He'll go back to Eastwick. Well launched forward ball, but well positioned defenders for Cashmere High School. The press here from Cashmere High School just unnerving this St. Thomas's defence. They've given it up. Cashmere looking to creates all sorts of problems again down that left-hand side. It's floated into the top of the 18-yard box. All sorts of shoving going on, but Kalk can't get his shot on target, and we're going to have a change. It's St. Thomas's who will make that change. Well, looks like it's taken off their front man. Tanche Makashima, Makarima, coming off. Wolves doing well there to get beyond one. Cover defences there. And just a bit of settle down from referee Nottage. Plenty of high spirits from these lads. Nice work from Kalk to get the ball under position for Cashmere High School. Clever from Craythorne. Nice attention back into Hindman. And clipped in. What a dangerous delivery here. It's going to sit down for one of the Cashmere players, but neither of them could decide who was going to have that shot. And the first yellow of the evening is going to come out and be pointed in the direction of newly introduced Morgan Kilkenny. Well, edging run out of the back there from the Cashmere High School student, and neither player willing to pull out of that one. And it was just a bad bit of timing in there from Kilkenny. Cashmere doing well here too. Got a great opportunity, and Eastwick able to pluck that one out of the air safely. Well, St. Thomas's will know that they've got more in the bank here. They're definitely capable of playing, stepping it up a gear. Just say Cashmere High School have deserved their lead so far. And they've passed it around well and been able to exploit some holes in this St. Thomas's defence. Nice work at the back there from Barrett. Here's a steal under all sorts of pressure, just doing well to clear it. And the connection there from Gallagher, just a bit too strong. Didn't quite get the shoulder-to-shoulder contact he was after. Ryu and Hindman on the ball. Float this one in. And it's high. Bread and butter there for Harry Eastwick, the Horsel United custodian. Still, just giving it back to him. Exchanging of passes. So they try to work their way out. Still, he's got to clip one on. A couple of willing chases here. Nice work from Gallagher. But Lovegrove also doing well there, just to maybe stop a possible corner. Cashmere just trying to work their way into an attacking position. It's just each side having a wee turn at possession before they overturn it. Now the space is being found. Still will go deep to Eastwick as they invite Cashmere onto them. Trying to create that space, they can then exploit. But Cashmere's press is pretty strong. They're going to make sure that they don't give this away. Steele's having to do a bit of a repair job on the Eastwick clearance. And Steele with a throw. Goes long. O'Connell and Kilkenny coming to a bit of a tidy up there, but still able to get the ball forward, but unfortunately can't retain possession. Cashmere. Passing the ball patiently forward. Out across the back. A few forward runs here. Finds Angau. Angau able to retain and go back inside to Barella. And it goes down the left-hand side. There's plenty of wheels down there, as we know. And there's a corner. Well, not sure who's roving down that left-hand side just yet. We might get to see him a bit closer in the second half, but my word, can he travel. Well, it's great to see the stand, see some of the stand full here at English Park. Plenty of people all around it. Haven't seen these scenes for quite some time. And St. Thomas's boys are starting to get in behind their lads as they try to stir them into action. But they've got the defensive duties on now. This ball's floated in from Cashmere High School. Bounces, stabbed out. Eastwick's got a hand to it. Pops it out. It's back in towards the goal. And oh my word, how did that not go in? Eastwick had a couple of parries at it. And what I probably sum up as a great save in the end. Absolutely desperate defence from St. Thomas's at this stage. As they'll try to ensure they don't concede another one before half time. Angau. Into, well, Kalk and left foot of Hindman. Easily dealt with by Eastwick. Steele leaving it behind and well tracked back. And Kalk, oh my word, he got a lot of that. Fortunately, Kilkenny was there to block it. Well, I'm impressed by the Cashmere High School attacking lineup. They're not giving up on anything. They're really making sure that St. Thomas's have to work hard to get the ball out from the back. The Cashmere attack is not just attacking. As soon as they're out of position, they're working hard to get it back. And that really is creating some issues for the side in blue. Well, good patience shown here from Cashmere High School for the moment. I know they're in control. Got the ball. Got St. Thomas's where they want him. Down the left-hand side they come. Driving, running, and across the 18-yard. Hyman thrashing one in. Bit of a mix-up. Another opportunity deflected. And out for another corner. Well, Eastwick could have been caught off-footed there, but happy to see it go wide. Well, the last corner here for Cashmere gave all sorts of trouble to the St. Thomas's defence. Let's see what they can do here. Two arms go up and it's gone. Right under the penalty spot. Up and one, directed goalward. I think it might have been Alex Walls there, was able to guard the post, hit it for Eastwick to gain position. Well won by Angier. Hindman can't quite connect his pass. The press is on again though from Cashmere High School. Well worked at the moment for St. Thomas's. Maybe a foul, waved on. Heyman taking off. He's just looking for some space to move into, but so far Cashmere High School are up to the challenge on that right-hand flank. Hindman clips one into the far post. Walls is there to get rid of it for the moment. And away comes Dempster. Pops it forward towards O'Connell, but just slightly ahead of him. And St. Thomas is doing well to just get the back four up as well to make sure that the Cashmere player would have been offside if he'd received it. Cashmere again, working down the left-hand flank. Brave work in there from Kalk. Heyman doing well. Oh, clever little work in there. And number six, Kilkenny, receiving another talking to. He's on a yellow card, and he'd want to watch himself. Ewan Hindman on the ball, who's drifted in some threatening balls in here today. Just the timing of the run there from the Cashmere High School attackers. Barrett working the ball out. Barrett's made the run forward, but pounced on by the Cashmere High School defence as they try to turn into some sort of attack. Oh, a bit of a rushed ball there from Gallagher. Had more time than he thought as he tried to connect with O'Connell to get St. Thomas's back on level pegging. Be Nottage. We're into Nottage time. Can't be too much left in this half. It has been dominated by Cashmere High School. St. Thomas has definitely came out of the gate pretty strong, but as the game progressed, Cashmere got more and more comfortable. And a goal from Jamie Jeffrey Daly is the difference so far. And Cashmere High School, definitely the happier of the two sides as they head to the changing room to try to work out what the second half's going to look like. We'll have a wee break. Please join us in 10 minutes for the second half of this Connetics School Premier First 11 competition. Well, welcome back to English Park for this Connetics School Premier First 11 final. Got Cashmere have the advantage so far with a 1-0 lead over St Thomas's. We've seen some absolutely spectacular halftime action out there from some of the super fans. And a few free sausages going down from Connetics have been appreciated too. I think the stand's absolutely chocker today, which is great to see. Fans are in pretty good voice. Here's a buckle up. I think we're going to be in for a decent second half here. Aaron, waiting for Aaron Nottage, referee, to get us underway. It's Cashmere. We'll get a chance to see the wheels that down this left-hand flank from Cashmere. It was Josh Craythorne and Lewis Carswell who show some good heels, clean heels as they work their way down. And off goes Carswell looking for an overlap there, but the ball's not gone his way just yet. Good patience, good connections here from Cashmere High School. Just drawing and passing. Clever little turnaround. It's an opportunity. Decent foot in there from Steele, as it was Josh Craythorne who tried to weave his way through. Decent connection there also from Ewan Hindman. Likes to get it on his left peg. And a decent strike, but Harry Eswick comfortable with it. And whistle going, and we've got an indirect free kick here. Eswick maybe just holding it up. Is it the 6-second rule maybe? Haven't seen that one applied for a while. There's a real good opportunity here for Cashmere High School. The walls lined up. And Nottage just reminding the wall, getting the wall back. Seems a few people have got themselves onto the park and that may just delay proceedings. Referee.
If we can just get those boys just to come behind the fence, please. If we can get everyone behind the fence, not on the field.
Good bit of enthusiasm from the crowd, but they've been reminded where they should be.
Yeah, all behind the fence, thank you. Thank you, gentlemen.
Nottage just going to wait for these players to...
Aaron, just wait until we've got those people moved.
Get right off the park is what the referee Nottage is trying to achieve. As I think it might be the St Thomas's fans just looking to add a bit of spice behind their team as they... ultimately just slowing proceedings down. Well, it's the St Thomas's defence who are now going to have to concentrate. There's an indirect free kick here for Cashmere High School. Standing over, it looks like Ewan Hindman, who's shown his ability with his left peg. It's Josh Craythorne with him. Just a wee touch and it's rocketed into the wall. Where's it fallen?
It's pinging around everywhere. Where's it going to land? Struck towards goal again. Hindman's in. Well defended in the end from the St. Thomas's group. And St. Thomas's have kept themselves in the game by defending that one. Well, we might hear from referee Nottage what that one was for. I can only assume it would have been the 6 second rule. O'Connell coming away with it. Nice work in there from Heyman, but the defence was strong. And Cashmere trying to turn something into an attack here. Searching ball forward from Carswell. Defended well from Barrett. Well played by St. Thomas's as they work their way and try to find some spaces. A player down at the moment. Come on, O'Connell going square into I think that was the Gallagher there, but there's an opportunity here for Cashmere as the ball squeezed in to make it two. Cashmere High School pouncing on a square pass. And unfortunately, it looks like we've got a player down for St. Thomas's, and it's a good bit of sportsmanship for him. Henry Lovegrove down here as he supports the St. Thomas's attacker. I think it might be Daniel Heyman as we search for who might have scored that goal. I think it might have been Liam Kalk, who's a top goal scorer for Cashmere High School. Rounded a couple of defenders and thrashed it in with his left peg beyond the despairing dive of Harry Eastwick.
Goal score by number 17, Liam Kalk.
Yep. Cashmere boys just helping. Yes, it is number 7, Daniel Heyman, who's come down with a bit of an injury there. St. Thomas's bench are going to have to react smartly here, try to either keep him, get him back on the field or replace him. Cashmere taking a great advantage here early in the second half. Carried on the work and the form they had in the first half. But I'm sure that won't be the end of it. And St. Thomas's. Very cool, Kenny. Well won back by Cashmere. Driving run forward, but well stopped by Gallagher. Retained back. Steele's able to get a foot in on it, and nice work from Eastwick to stop that one rolling out for a corner. Been a couple of changes. I could see Tefara Kerry McGregor out there for St. Thomas's. And is it going to be a throw in there or a throw in? As Josh Craythorne tried to weave himself into some opportunities. Oh, wasteful there from Gallagher, who's just given the ball back to Cashmere. I'm sure his teammates would have preferred a bit more composure, as they're desperate to have that chance to get themselves on the ball, St. Thomas's. But it's been Cashmere High School who've turned up so far here today. And here they come again. Space to play with on the left foot. Driven across. It's in the 6-yard box. Can he turn and shoot? Unfortunately, not able to keep in control there. Cashmere attacker. And cleared by Steele. Good throw, well contested from McGregor. Well, earlier on today, we had the plate final, or the championship final, with between Middleton Grange and St Andrews College. Middleton Grange there coming second to St Andrews, losing that one 3-2. Had such a great season in the championship phase. But St Andrews finishing the stronger. And away we go for Cashmere, working their way into the box again. And there's an opportunity for a penalty kick, and it is given. Well, it was a weaving run that drew the defence into the foul. And I don't think referee Nottage had much deliberation around that one. Well, this could really put this one to bed here, 10 minutes into the second half. Well, who have we got stepping up to take this one? Might be Josh Craythorne. He's gone wide. Head and hand stuff. No, it just proves how tough it is to take a penalty. Well, he didn't give Eastwick any chance of saving that. He put it wide himself. Well, a wee opportunity for a wee glimpse that maybe could stir St Thomas's back into action. Kilkenny sending one forward, but cut out well from the Cashmere. And Kilkenny losing his feet there again, but unable to be effective. Oh, a decent square ball in here. There's another opportunity for a strike, and well, he needed the goal to be 10 times bigger if that one was going to go anywhere near being in. Cashmere continue to pile the pressure on this St Thomas's defence. They edge their way down the field. A weak glimpse of opportunity might be in the corner, to the corner. They will go. Sending some people, big men forward. Be Campbell Buck and Kieran Barrett, centre backs who will go forward. Buck's gone in on the keeper. There's all sorts of pushing and shoving going on in there, and Nottage will once again go and sort them out. I don't think there's anything wrong with Campbell Buck standing beside the keeper. Must be swung in. It's high. It's in. To the middle, and we're battered away, flicked back in and over. decent effort from O'Connell. And the diminutive keeper, Henry Lovegrove, he's given away a foot in height to some of these players out there, but managed to get up and swat it away. Here come Cashmere High School, but O'Connell is blocking the advancement there of Lewis Carswell. Nope, I beg your pardon, it's Daniel Hayward who's on there now. Cashmere, looking it forward, retaining it, clever little flick, but it goes nowhere. Once again, the retreating defence from Cashmere High School is energetic. It's intensive. And St Thomas is just unable to find their way forward. Here comes Wall. Ball squeezed in, but away it's launched by Cashmere High School. As far as Eastwick gets it to Buck. Surging forward here. Good cover defence from Cashmere. And O'Connell's touch just eluding him there as he tried to get in behind the Cashmere defence. Out to Carswell. O'Connell stepping on, but well won by Buck. Carswell with the throw. Launches it forward. It's in the area, bouncing awkwardly. Well cleared. Oh, a decent challenge in there. Where's that card going? Someone deserves it. Seamus Gallagher just scything through the defence and brought to an end there. And it's Daniel Haywood for Cashmere High School who will receive a yellow. Well, it was a somewhat cynical takedown, really. Launched forward. Not going anywhere in Cashmere. Work hard to create another attack through Captain Hindman. Big sweeping ball out, but well won by Buck. Buck receiving a kick in the leg for his troubles, and I wouldn't be surprised to see another card come out here. Things just getting a wee bit silly. Another card. Unnecessary. And Cashmere, that two goals up. And really, it was number two there, Lewis Caswell, who off the ball got involved in something he didn't need to. But we're back underway playing football. Okay, away goes Jeffrey Daly, but can't get it under. Well, a decent throw forward here, and good wheels shown, but the touch eludes him. Here come some Thomases, but great injection of Carswell there to save the day. And the free kick here for Cashmere High School in a decent area. Just taking this one quickly. Flicked in. This one could be a corner. Yes, it is. Seems to be a wee bit of disagreement, but Nottage is pretty sure. And Cashmere will try to put this one to bed. The one forward for St Thomas's as it drifts in towards the penalty spot. It's met well, but O'Connell's on the ball. Clips it forward. Bowls in. Gets the ball back. Tenacious defending. Here's an opportunity for McGregor. Gets into the 18-yard line. Freshes it, but what cover defending. Well, not quite sure who made the rescuing run there, but just as Te Whare Kauri McGregor was about to unleash, the Cashmere defence had come back and saved Henry Lovegrove from making a save. And once again, it's Lovegrove who having to contend with some tall timber in the 6-yard box. It's Buck in there for St Thomas's. He's been shoved to and fro by the Cashmere defence as they try to disrupt it. Swung right in, and where's it got it? Well, Lovegrove seemed to have had that one, but ultimately dropped it, I imagine, or he didn't have it in the end, and Cashmere lucky to get away with that one. Well, it's happened a couple of times now where the ball's been bouncing around in that defensive 6-yard of Cashmere High School, and St Thomas's just haven't been in the right place at the right time to be able to poke those ones away. And we're going to see a change here. Looks like coaching staff for Cashmere just making a couple of changes. Craig Squire and Tom Wilkinson, co-coaches for Cashmere High School, who are the defending champions. They've done well here. The last year they accounted for Shirley Boys High School 3-0. St Thomas's were third last year on the third, fourth playoff after an undefeated season. And it was 2 years ago in 2021 where these two met in the third and fourth playoff, which Cashmere won. And St Thomas has just caught offside there, and Cashmere Walker look to consolidate. St Thomas is looking to, oh, they're just holding. Maybe they want to try to create some errors. They're going to have to press as a team, keeping some spare players at the back in St Thomas's. Kilkenny unable to bring it under control. Up he goes, but he can only flick it on. Launched forward, miscontrolled. St Thomas is again, the ball just not going their way. So bounces around everywhere. Well worked, and here comes Cashmere through Kilk. Jeffrey Daly there, winning a throw. And Captain Ewan Hindman in there, just leaving a foot in. Steele receives the ball back. Puts it into the midfield to Kilkenny, whose touch eludes him. Steele pumps it up and over. Who's going to bring it down? Nice bit of footwork in there from the Cashmere midfielder. There's an opportunity for McGregor to go hunting. Cashmere clear well, and Steele's under pressure. Done well there to keep it in and get it forward, but fortunate for him. Bit of miscontrol from Carswell. Steele closed down quickly by number 17, Kelk. Steele, direction of McGregor, tries to work his way out, but the defence is up for the challenge. Launch forward by Kelk. Now come Cashmere. Oh, the opportunity switches on, but it's a delightful ball forward and brought under control, but the line assistant referee was on in the right place. Spotted it. Just creep forward a wee bit too early. 10 minutes to go in this Canterbury School Premier First 11 competition final. Here's some Thomases trying to get themselves on the board. My word, would the crowd love this. Headers up. Oh, and an amazing effort there. It's gone for a corner. Well, it was some brain fade in there from the Cashmere High School defender, who was very fortunate that the ball was spotted to go out for a corner. You don't clear it into the middle of the box, ladies and gentlemen. Now they're up to defend it near post corner. Captain Heyman able to clear. And Wall's got some work to do. Done well there, defender, and but unfortunately he not done within the laws of the game, and he'll receive a yellow. Well, I'm not too sure if these cards will carry into tournament football, but both these teams will be looking forward to a full week of football next week here. Games being played at St Albans Park, English Park, Foster Park, United Sports Centre and Kendall Park next week. Head along to New Zealand Secondary Schools football website and you'll be able to see the draw there, I'm sure. And Cashmere working the ball well again, as they've done in various moments. They'll go all the way back to Lovegrove, who will compose things. Clip the forward by Angau. Well won by Buck. Carswell to take the throw. Launches it forward. O'Connell fighting away, trying to lead his team, inspire his team into finding a goal or two. As the clock ticks away, here's McGregor. A touch round one, but the defence is there. Wall gets it forward. Plenty of space to work in, but a lazy pass cut out well by Cashmere. And a nasty bit of connection there.
spotted by referee Nottage. And Cashmere go deep. Around the back they go. Punch. Great little turn and run forward from Calc. But well, one back, Bison Thomas's, and here comes Barrett. Roving forward from a centre back position. Releasing his teammate down the left. He tries to weave around his defence, but Cashmere defence up for that challenge. And away they work with just over 6 minutes on the clock. Kilkenny working across and forward. Long range strike here from number 17, Corsi. Met by a maroon and yellow wall. Eastwick. Cashmere just launching it forward, keeping the ball where they want it, well away from their goal. It's all for St. Thomas's to do. Nearly job done for Cashmere High School. As a second title in as many years. Barrett doing well there. Steel. Out to Buck. And unceremoniously kicked out. Into the St. Thomas fan group by Liam Calc. Buck, under pressure, gets it across to Barrett. Launches forward, but cut out by Cashmere. And here comes Calc. Well chased. Plenty of players around him. Nudged in the back there from Gallagher. He'll receive a yellow card for his troubles. Just tried to bully his way in. And Cashmere asking for 10 here. They set something up to really try to put the pressure on the Harry Eastwick goal. Little wee change here for Cashmere High School. Taking a while to do, but Jackson Barella on the ball. Fair mid base player. Whips it in to near postal on the ground. Fallen to, I think it might have been Carswell there. Got a decent bit of it, but not on target. Now comes Barrett. Barrett trying to drive out. He's giving away position here. What can Cashmere High School make of this? Wall is there. Defended well today. Barrett skips forward. Drives by, but good body position. And Nottage had no choice there. But just great little body position there from the Cashmere defender. Cashmere just
Here comes Wall. Launches forward. Who's on the end of this? It's a wee sniff of opportunity as they get into the 18-yard box here. Keeps his feet only just. Just a goal kick. Well, I had a wee... A few St. Thomas fans there hoping and praying for a penalty, but nothing really in there. Carswell. Buck. The poor header. Sometimes it can be a bit tricky here under the lights to just adjust. Wall. Back to Eastwick. Steele. Clips it forward, but Cashmere High School able to consolidate some position. Into the corner it goes. Steele try to keep this in or just quickly get it back to Eastwick as time's now up on the clock. The moment's away. Could really has all been all Cashmere High School today. Maybe the early stages where there's a wee sniff in there for St. Thomas's, but in a well-constructed defence of the title by Cashmere High School. And there. Tenacity on defence really has continued to create them create chances for them. And really just put a stop to any attack that St. Thomas has tried to start. Last minute subs just happening here. Forward go Cashmere. One. Wall. Driving forward. Unnecessary slide in there. And yellow card there for Captain Hindman. In the dying stages. Well, St. Thomas's will throw everything forward here just to try to get a bit of a consolation maybe. Well, that wall of maroon and yellow. Kilkenny finding no way through it. It's a hopeful effort forward as Nottage looks at his watch. Keeper Lovegrove collects the ball for what could be his last goal kick. Forward go Cashmere. McGregor trying to it's an opportunity here to round things out as Kelk drives into the box, but his touch just gets away from him and Eastwick doing well there to come out and close down. McGregor on the ball, trying to work hard for the for something. Here comes a wee opportunity. Could be a one last corner here for St. Thomas's as they try desperately to get on the board. Eastwick's going to get up there, add to the numbers. It's all but one committed to the area. Swung in, he's falling on Eastwick, it's fallen down into this, thrashed in, but blocked by the maroon and yellow wall. And it will be Cashmere High School celebrating for this
Connetics school premier first 11 final, as the Cashmere fans join their team on the field in celebration. Title defended. A 2-0 result for Cashmere High School. Goals to Jamie Jeffrey Daly and Liam Kalk have been the difference here tonight. Thank you for tuning in. Make sure you do get around the fields next week. Will there be plenty of secondary school football as the boys' premier tournament here in Christchurch starts on Monday. Both of these teams will be featuring alongside of plenty of sides coming down from the North Island. My name's Craig Crawford. It's been great to bring you this match. Good evening.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, can we have all the non-playing people off the field? We'll get this presentation underway. All right, can we have everybody off the field, please? Except for the players and officials. Grab a seat and there's something to stand. And a wee challenge for all of you sitting in the stand. Let's make sure we can get our rubbish down to the front, please. Leave the stadium as clean as you found it. It'll be awesome. Thank you, everybody. Righto, fellas, everybody off the field. Looks like there's a few people having a kick around over there. If you guys can make your way to the sideline, please. Well, on behalf of Mainland Football, thank you for all coming along and making this a great occasion. It was well supported from all fans, and it really does add to the occasion. It's been a long, hard season for the 14th side who started off this competition, and no doubt this week we'll all be entertained by this Premier Boys Football Tournament that will be held here in Christchurch. So if you get the chance to go out and support your side again, please do. Our first thanks goes out to our competition sponsors, Connetics. Oh, you can put your hands together if you tasted one of those sausages, free sausages. I definitely appreciated a couple of those on a cool night like tonight. And I'll hand over to John Thompson, who's got a few words to say on Connetics' behalf.
Thanks, Craig. Hey, look, it's a pleasure to be here again, sponsoring secondary school sports. We sponsor the football, we also sponsor the hockey. We believe and are committed to actually giving back to the community that we work with. And we really appreciate the support that you've given to this event over the past season. I'd also like to thank Secondary School Sports and also Mainland Football for partnering with us. Really appreciate it. And thanks to both teams for putting on a fantastic game, but befitting of a final. Also, the officials really appreciate their work out there today as well. Look, just a bit of a plug for Connetics Limited. We're in the electricity industry. There's a lot of challenges going ahead in the next few years. So if you're looking for a career, you're young and you're interested in a career, male or female, we've got jobs going over the next few years. So I'd like you to have a look at www.connetics.co.nz or careers@connetics.co.nz. Look, there's an option there for anyone who's wanting to make a contribution to society. So look us up and look forward to seeing you out there. So look, thanks Craig, and all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, John. So now I call on John and Emma Lloyd to present the medals to our officials of today. You guys can come forward. Thank you. Thank you very much to the officials and our finalists today, St Thomas's of Canterbury. Now invite the tonight's winners, Cashmere High School, to come forward. I've got Captain Ewan here to say a few words on behalf of Cashmere High School.
Well,
First of all, we just want to say a big thank you to St. Thomas. They were really good today. I think the scoreline did them quite harshly, but such a good battle. And I think I speak for all of us when I say they were incredible. So round of applause for them. And I just want to thank the officials, the supporters, Connetics, all the mainland for organising this. And boys, can we have a big round of applause for the supporters?
Congratulations, there's a bit of silverware over there for you, Ewan. Ewan, go and grab your silverware, mate. Put your hands together for the school premier first 11 boys champions of 2023. Cashmere High School! Well, once again, on behalf of Mainland Football, thank you all for attending. We'd appreciate you tidying up after yourselves. On the way out, just make sure the rubbish gets down to the front here, that'd be great. Thanks again to Connetics. All the best to everybody competing in their tournament week next week. And a safe ride home to everybody. Thank you.